As we explore the vastness of the universe, our curiosity is sparked by the mysteries that surround us. Celestial bodies and invisible forces create a complex tapestry, inviting us to unravel their secrets. At the forefront of our journey is the Large Hadron Collider, a marvel of human ingenuity. This immense machine may hold the key to deciphering the riddles of the cosmos. CERN, where the Large Hadron Collider is located, is home to the most complicated machine ever built. Its purpose is to explore the universe, driven by our fascination with understanding how it works. The machine accelerates protons, the nuclei of hydrogen, to an incredible 99.999999% of the speed of light. These protons, traveling around the collider's ring 11,000 times a second, collide with each other, generating up to 600 million collisions every second. In recreating conditions present less than a billionth of a second after the universe began, we aim to uncover the fundamental laws that govern our cosmos. This engineering marvel operates at a temperature lower than minus 271 degrees Celsius, just 1.9 degrees above absolute zero, colder than the universe itself. The conditions it simulates take us back in time when the universe was hot and dense, revealing its simpler and more understandable nature. We, along with stars, planets, and galaxies, are products of an old and cold universe. Comparing this to the complexity of a melting snowflake, we find that the universe, too, becomes simpler as we rewind time and explore hotter conditions. In our cosmic journey, we encounter mysteries that challenge our understanding. One such enigma is the matter-antimatter asymmetry problem. According to the Big Bang theory, equal amounts of matter and antimatter should have been produced, leading to mutual annihilation. Yet, we exist in a universe dominated by matter. The cosmic scales were somehow tilted in favor of our existence. Beyond what we can see lies the enigmatic presence of dark matter, an unseen cosmic glue constituting 85% of the universe's mass. It shapes galaxies and holds them together, neither emitting nor absorbing light. Another mysterious force, dark energy, propels the universe's expansion, accounting for nearly 70% of its total energy content. As galaxies drift apart due to dark energy, we ponder the origins and consequences of this cosmic repulsion. As we delve into the depths of the cosmos, we are confronted by one of the most perplexing riddles: what existed before the Big Bang? The precision with which we describe the universe's evolution, from less than a billionth of a second after the Big Bang to the present, raises remarkable questions about our knowledge. How do we count galaxies or measure the age and mass of celestial bodies? The scientific method, a cornerstone of human inquiry, guides our quest to unveil the universe's mysteries. Through rigorous observation, experimentation, and analysis, we build a scaffold of knowledge anchored in evidence. This process brings us closer to understanding the enigmatic workings of the cosmos. In our exploration, we encounter the genius of Albert Einstein and his groundbreaking theory of general relativity, the cornerstone of modern cosmology. This theory, based on gravity, redefines our understanding of the universe's fundamental principles. Einstein's theory, produced in 1915, emerged from thoughts he had for over a decade. It provides a new perspective on gravity, where the curvature of space and time, caused by mass, replaces the traditional idea of a force pulling objects. This theory not only explains the behavior of planets, but also predicts the history and future of the entire universe, shaping the foundation of modern cosmology. In explaining Einstein's ideas, let's imagine Newton and an apple. Newton didn't think the apple fell because the Earth pulled it down. Instead, he believed the apple hit him because he was moving upward, sort of like a headbutt. This idea is quite the opposite of what we might expect. Einstein's brilliance comes in when we look at astronauts in the International Space Station. Even though they're falling towards Earth, it seems like no forces are acting on them. Picture an astronaut letting go of a cup of water, placing a feather or a heavy mass in the air, they all seem to stay in place. This puzzled Newton, as his theory didn't adequately explain why all things fall at the same rate in a gravitational field when air resistance is removed. Here, Einstein stepped in with a revolutionary idea. Instead of thinking of gravity as a force, he imagined it as the curvature of space and time. In 1905, he had already merged space and time, and now he added mass to the mix. So, according to Einstein, the reason Earth orbits the Sun is that the Sun curves space and time, making a straight line around the Sun in orbit. Einstein then wondered if he could apply this idea to the entire universe. If matter were uniformly distributed, his theory suggested that the universe could either be expanding or contracting. This brought him to the prediction of the Big Bang, the idea that the universe originated from a smaller state in the past. To simplify, Einstein's theory of gravity is like envisioning the universe as a storybook. If we know how matter is spread across the universe, the theory tells us the past, present, and future of the universe, just like predicting the positions of planets. This bold theory, developed with the help of a Belgian priest named Georges Lemaître, became the foundation of understanding the universe's origins. Thanks for joining us on this cosmic journey. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the video on your screen for more mind-bending content. Until next time, keep gazing at the stars.